What's up, guys? Kurt here with another 5-minute guitar lesson. Let's grab a C chord and check out our strumming pattern for this song. So our strumming pattern is going to be down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up. So then when we bring that to full speed, it sounds like this. And this is the strumming pattern we're going to use for basically the entire song. So our chords for the verse are pretty straightforward. We've got C, F, and A minor. The only weird thing is that on the second line where he says to hear you knocking at my door, we're gonna walk down from C to A minor. So we're gonna play a C, then you're gonna take your third finger off and put your second finger on the second fret of the fifth string here, play that, and then go to an A minor. So it's gonna be C, walk down to A minor. So just watch out for that, and I'll play it for you now and you can follow along. That we're going to move into the chorus, and we've already got our strumming pattern, so it's going to make that pretty easy. Our chords are going to be A minor, F, C, and G. And we're just going to play each chord for 4 run-throughs of the strumming pattern before switching chords. But if you next, we've got an interlude, which is going to be the same as the verse, and then we've got another verse and another chorus, which are the same as the first verse and chorus. After that, we're going to go into an instrumental section where the chords change up a bit, and we're going to be switching between a D minor and a G. But again, the same strumming pattern, which makes it pretty easy. Then we're going to move into the bridge, and this is where the song kind of picks up a bit. The chords are the same as in the chorus, and they change at the same spots, and you can just use the same strumming pattern if you want to, but if you want to pick it up a bit and add on to the energy of the song, you can just switch to straight alternating strums for this part. It'll just make the song a little more interesting, make your playing a little bit more interesting, and make you sound better. After the bridge, there's another instrumental section and then a final chorus, and both of these you can play the exact same as the bridge. And with that, you can play the entire song. This one's pretty straightforward to get, but it does have a pretty fun strumming pattern to play, so hopefully you guys enjoy learning this song. I'll see you in the next lesson.